has greet you.
Preste esse colher da tem vas pastor.
That you met Jesus.
Estou Jesus.
And Jesus has lifted you up.
Estou Jesus. The focus part was not for the Bible.
That you are not where you used to be.
Estou vendo o jeito de estar
that now you are sitting for the Lord by Himself.
Estou vendo ter sentido.
And he wants you to join hands with him.
Jesus also to be with
so that as he has helped your life,
to so be taken to your brother God Bog Pamova,
clean you up,
that you can bog as well,
raise you up,
God Bog for the mind.
He wants to use you to raise many other people up.
So be taken to your brother Bog was exposed one, should put the mind to give.
And I count it a great privilege to be with you this afternoon. And I count this meeting one of the greatest meetings since I came. We're going to look at the Bible together. We're talking about building.
Make a thing strong.
Yeah. There are many things we build in life. Number one, we build our lives. Number two, we build up families. Number three, we can build a city. Number four, we can build a whole nation. And God can use us to lay the foundation of building our world. So first of all, you build your life. Then you move on and build your family. Then you want to build your community. And now to build a city. And cities make up a nation. When I first came to know the Lord, there was a particular song they were always singing. And the song started with a question. It says, where will you spend eternity? This question comes to you and me. The next line, tell me what your answer will be. Where will you spend eternity? The chorus says, eternity, eternity. Where will you spend eternity? I've had it a lot of times. But I didn't really understand. It was much, much later. I began to understand that eternity is more than 1 year, more than 10 years, more than 100 years, more than 1 million years, more than millions and millions and millions of years. So I began to understand that song. Where will you spend eternity? After I knew I was born again, where I will spend eternity was no more a question. I
mean,
Jesus went to prepare a place for me. But that same song brought another question to me. Where will they spend eternity? This question now comes to you and to me. Our neighbors, our relatives, the people who are like what we used to be, the alcoholics,
those
who are into drugs. After I answered the question, where will I spend eternity? I'm not confronted with the question, where will they spend eternity? That is what then brings up in my mind. My life has been built up. Your life has been built up. Because of this second question about them. That's why we want to begin to find out now, what do we do? So that they will spend eternity in a good place where we want to spend eternity.
No, Vaishnavas are the pravilitam take them in
front. And that's why we want to talk about building lives for His eternal kingdom.
Поэтому мы сегодня будем говорить о строительстве, о том, как создать, строить,
building other people's lives for the eternal kingdom.
Как строить жизнь для вечности?
Well, we're talking about building.
Когда мы говорим о строительстве.
What if you are saved and you're a child of God, you are going to heaven?
Допустим, мы с вами спасены, имеем дом на небо.
There's no house to live.
No, даже если мы спасены, но нигде жить здесь на земле.
Your life is built, but there's no shelter.
No, человек спасен, но нигде ему жить.
Your life is built up, but your family is not built up.
Человек спасен, но нет у него семьи.
That means we're not only concerned about ourselves personally.
Поэтому после спасения мы начинаем думать о других.
We're concerned about other people.
Мы нужно начинать думать о других людях.
That's why we're talking today about building.
Мы говорим сегодня о строительстве.
Villages.
No, maybe solar.
Cities.
Города.
Or people that can live in security.
Или создать людей.
Communities of people that can live righteous lives. And the imposition of kingdom principles upon villages and cities and communities. You never build if there's no architect. Architects never build if they don't have a sketch. If they don't have a plan. You never have a plan if you don't have a vision or a dream. This great work of building, how will it start? If you have started already, how will it continue? There's a particular book in the Bible.
Yes, Master Psalm Bible.
That is devoted to building. And it is the book of Nehemiah. In this book of Nehemiah, we look at the way he came into starting the building. Before you can start building a city, a city of refuge, a city of righteousness, a city where there is security, a city where people's lives are precious are taken care of. There must be a desire in your heart. And it must be a kind of passionate desire. An undying desire. A kind of desire you cannot exchange for any other thing. How does that desire come? If you look at Nehemiah, and you look at chapter 1, you will see how Nehemiah had this passionate desire. I just read some verses to you. Chapter 1, verse 2. It says, Ananias, one of my brethren came, and he and certain men of Judah, and I asked them concerning the Jews that had escaped, which were led of the captivity, and concerning Jerusalem.
Второе, третье стих. И пришел Анани, один из братьев моих, он имел сколько человек из Иудеи, и спросил я их об уцелевших Иудея.
The first thing you are going to notice there is interaction.
There
are some people that they come to know the Lord. Their sins are forgiven. Their lives are clean. They are now happy. They say, praise the Lord. I'm now a child of God. Praise the Lord. I used to be an alcoholic. I used to be into drugs. But now things have changed. But they never go back to interact with the people that are still in the pitch
where they were.
They will never have any vision.
There will
be no dream of building the city of refuge. It is when you go back to those people
and there is
interaction with them. So people who are in Kievan capital, they don't know anything about the villages all around the country. The good people, religious people, evangelical Pentecostal people, and living good lives. They work in an air-conditioned office. And they go to a good church. There is no interaction with the people who are suffering. And so if you tell them, let's build a city of refuge, they cannot understand because there's no investigation.
But
when you go around the country, you see that this village is abandoned. That other village is abandoned. When you go around and you see there's no pipeline water in this village, and you see how people are drinking water out of the well to drink. Can you imagine during the cold winter when there's no gas to bring heat to the family? But it is investigation that makes you to discover the need. So number one, we know that we have an interaction with
them. Number two,
there was investigation, finding out.
That's
what led to number three now, information.
Information.
That's how we begin to have vision. We need information. How many people are sleeping under the bridge? How many people are dying away in the prisons? How many people appear incurable? What's the proportion of alcoholics in the country? How many people have been abandoned by their families? Without information, there will be nothing to stir you up. To know that there is something for us to do at this time.
Yes, they was need the information at least. When the police met in no in when the police met was push no. The show next chef was push that should be days over.
If you look at verse 4 of this chapter,
it
says, and it came to pass when I heard these words that I sat down and I wept and I mourned certain days. I even fasted and I prayed before the God of heaven. We call that internalization. That is, you take the information you got from outside, you put it inside your heart, it begins to stir something in your heart, you make it personal, internal internalization.
Когда мы получаем информацию, что творится в стране, не надо просто, чтобы с одной уха заслетело и другое вылетело. Надо наоборот размышлять об этой проблеме, чтобы это стало бременем для нас.
Let me explain what I mean.
Я объясню.
Let's say, for example, as we go out of this room.
Допустим, мы выходим отсюда.
Oh, you have information that somebody had accident.
И вы слышали, что кто-то умер от передозировки или попал в аварию.
You don't know his name.
Вы не знаете, как его зовут.
Never met him. An accident took place there.
No, вы просто слышали.
Three people died.
Что три человека умерли.
You don't make it internal.
No, вы просто слышали. Oh,
what a pity somebody died.
No, no.
Somebody came to you again.
No, yes, they told that to
go. Do you know this name?
Is that's
my brother.
I that my brother.
Did you hear that accident took place?
And of course it's not.
And we saw the identity card of one of those people.
Когда ты начинаешь слышать, что это один из твоих людей, из троих, которые умерли,
this is the name.
Брат.
This is the name.
Брат, твой брат.
That information you had before. That didn't make any impression on you. Now there is a name, there is a face, there is a person attached to that
information.
All of a sudden you begin to cry. You had that same information before. But because it wasn't internalized.
It didn't
have any impact on you. The same thing as we interact with the people who are suffering.
For that, make sure that we are Jesus.
As there is investigation of the people who are suffering.
Problem, they need that impression.
As well, the information about them.
No, we don't need to keep up.
We bring that information internal.
We don't need no. Say they are feed it.
That's why we begin to say, in this life I'm living, I will do something about
it.
Now, do you understand why when we come to church, we have about 4,000 people in the church, and then you are part of that church, and the pastor comes out, and the pastor is speaking with passion, he's almost crying.
He pastor pastor
is said we're going to build cities of refuge.
He pastor national rascals, but
all these villages that I found, we're going to repossess them.
As a visitor, can we not pass out?
And he says, I need volunteers.
He pastor government top ahead.
I need people that will give their time and their talent, their family, every resource they have. And then, so while the pastor is saying that passionately,
but the pastor clash in the scene.
There's somebody by your side.
What the first little best is?
So you know, playing with something else. It shuts off the pastor. But you're paying attention.
And the
pastor said, "Now we're going to do it." If you are making a decision to get involved. I need you right now. Make a commitment. The person by your side is just, you know, while the pastor is still looking at this and looking at that. And you are almost crying. You said, I wish I had three lives. I will give three lives to this one.
Pastor, I go to the gospel in here. That's what Jesus will do.
I wish I had money in the bank to buy over all this whole village and that. I will give it right now. Then you pray and pray and pray. And after that meeting, you go to the pastor. Pastor, count on me, we're going to do this together. What's the difference between you and that person sitting by your side? The other person had the same information that you've got. But the other person did not internalize that information. But you, the information came into your heart and was like a dagger in your heart. Another thing that Nehemiah began to do. The next point, intercession. Once that thing comes in your heart and it arrests your mind, arrests your heart, this is it for the rest of my life. This is what you do. You begin to pray. That information leads to internalization and leads to intercession.
So it's an information and a chance to be a celebration of the fact that it's a brilliant national to cut the Malisa.
That's why Nehemiah began to pray.
What was she more Nehemiah start Malisa?
And it is the same thing that works in our lives.
Don't you say we will not say
that we also make intercession to the Lord.
Me too, she does the delatage
Sarah. And then when he was praying,
Malisa,
you see the way Nehemiah prayed. There is something significant in the prayer of Nehemiah in verse 7. In verse 7, he said, "We have dealt very corruptly." We call that interpretation. If we do not have the right interpretation, we're not going to do much in life. When people hear the information that they are leaving the villages and then they are coming to the city, the interpretation of some people is that is the new state, that's the new lifestyle. People want to live in the urban cities. They don't attribute it to corruption in the government. To order the development of those villages. That because they don't have the amenities we have in the city, that's why they're running away. When people hear that some people are alcoholics, the interpretation of some is in their gene, it is in their makeup. Nobody's fault, that's his genes. Somebody is on drugs. They say it is the influence of society upon him. And with that wrong interpretation, nobody is going to make any effort to solve any problem. When we come to the foundation of the prayer, that this is because of corruption in our land. And that if we're going to do anything, we need to solve this problem of corruption.
No, yes, if it is severe, cat, no, it is what you see, it is what you believe, can I tell me?
It is that proper interpretation that brings the solution.
But even though for eta, brevia, and not to be a no delight to be a south shastigam.
That's the
difference between
those of us who are here and the other people who are not here.
What machine they can raise was for pollution, that's supposed to be the talk of pollution. No, talk of pollution, it will show.
If everybody in the church
will
have the information we have, if everybody in the church we have the same internalization that we have of that information, if everybody in our church here
will
have the same passion, the same intercession, this room will not contain us discussing about building cities of refuge.
To be get off
well, thank God, it's a good start.
Não ничего. Пускай это будет мало начало, но все-таки начало.
Some people pass the information to Nehemiah. It is your turn. Go pass the information to other people.
Кто-то спас Нехемия. И теперь у него премия за других людей. Кто-то также тебя спас. Теперь у тебя должна быть премия за других.
Number 7.
Следующий пункт.
Nehemiah was talking to God.
Nehemiah говорил с Богом.
He wanted the intervention of heaven on the situation.
Почему он говорил с Богом? Он хотел, чтобы небо вмешало ситуацию на земле.
Intervention of heaven to the situation.
Чтобы не только своими силами, а и сюда делали.
And it is that intervention that has brought us here.
Но чтобы Божья сила была выпущена,
the conditions of these abandoned villages, they are going to improve because of you. Because of us.
И мы с вами должны видеть эти города, и мы должны знать, что благодаря нам тысячи, тысячи людей оживут.
And this is how God Himself brings the vision unto us.
И вери Богу, что Бог нам поможет в этом.
I want you to think about those things who have said.
Подумайте об этом.
Do you still have interaction with those who are falling, those who are alcoholics, those who are into drugs?
Ви получили освобождение, ви все еще общаетесь, щоб видеть, як другі з миром, щоб видеть, які жизни люди, які не освобождені, і що живуть.
I'm sure you are not acting like a holier-than-thou person.
Я надеюсь, що ви не думаєте, що я вже поспався, зачем це саме?
I'm sure you are not isolating yourself.
Я надеюсь, що ви не із таких людей, які говорять, що я не спасний, зачем не стиме?
You're not insulating yourself from the people that have problems in this land.
Не дай Бог, щоб ви не стали такими людьми, кому помогли, які тепер говорять, а зачем мені доник не дела, я для себе вирушив.
I'm sure you are concerned.
Дай Бог, щоб ми з вами були
людьми. I'm sure the sin is painting on inside of you.
Щоб ми переживали, мислили, що боль всегда, що ні один чоловік уже не
зможе спати. Someone will rescue me, I'm going to rescue thousands of people.
Ні одна душа уже не дожне так умирав, як я умирав.
Somebody provide a shelter for me, I'm going to provide shelter for thousands of people.
Якщо мені допоможе, я помогу, і я докажу, що все можна допомогти.
Somebody gives me refuge, I'm going to bring refuge to other people.
Якщо мені кому-то хто пропащив, спасти, я спасу навіть самого последнього.
The person who brought me out is not a very rich man, not richer than I am today. And if he could do it, I'm going to do it to other people.
Мне не надо иметь деньги, мне не надо иметь славу, мне нужно только иметь бремя за эти людей.
What others have done for me, I'm going to do for many others.
То, что Бог делает для меня через других людей, через меня, Он также спасет тысячи других жизней.
That brings me to the next thing now.
Вот почему, но следующее, что я буду говорить.
Dedication to build.
Нужно, чтобы у нас было посвящение.
There's a positive dedication.
Созидать жизнь других.
I hear about it and I just say, okay, that's all right, somebody else will do it.
Вы знаете, есть иногда некоторые верующие, которые говорят, ну, города верующие, это кто-то к этому призван,
кто-то к этому призван. Look at where you
are today.
You have a good job.
Вы, допустим, смотрите на себя на сегодняшний день.
Then you have good qualification.
Теперь вам помогает получить образование, вам помогает профессию.
God used somebody, God used the church to bring you out and to bring you to this wonderful level. That's why I say praise the Lord, congratulations. God has brought you and lifted you up.
So what's the box pass?
Nehemiah was the king's cupbearer.
Вот Неемия, допустим, он тоже имел проблему, и Бог его уже спас, и он начал нарушить работу прямо во дворах у
Саня. It was an enviable job that he had.
Это работа, о которой все мечтали.
He saw the king every day.
Он видел Саня каждый день.
That king was a great emperor over a great empire.
Он это обслуживал этого великого Саня.
The life of the king depended upon Nehemiah. And then all the people that were coming from foreign nations, they had to see Nehemiah because he was a king cupbearer.
То есть его мечта уже сбилась. Это мечта, которую многие, они уже получили, он уже получил то, о чем другие мечтали.
I had a great privilege of meeting many ambassadors from many countries.
Свои личные вопросы решили. То есть он имел привилегии, встречался с самыми лидерами.
But when the information about the down and out people in his nation, when it came to him, he abandoned that, said, this one requires my effort.
Но когда он услышал, что люди там страдают, откуда его вывезли, откуда он приехал, что там люди умирают.
The positive dedication. It is that dedication that helps us to do something in life. How did he carry out that dedication?
Number one, prayer.
Is the foundation of all eternal and profitable projects.
If
we're going to do anything substantial, the first thing to start in our dedication to this work is prayer.
But
there are many people that pray.
Impossible.
Wake up in the morning.
Oh
God in heaven. This country is corrupt.
Oh, gospel is bad.
Many people who are down and out. Too many alcoholics. Violence in the families. Husbands are beating their wives. Husbands are spending the money they ought to spend on their children. They spend on alcohol. Oh God, save our country.
Oh God, but it's bad.
Oh God, save our country.
It's bad.
They pray and they do nothing.
More.
And nothing changes.
And
we must go from prayer and go to the next point.
Plan.
We must plan to make sure that this prayer we're praying is answered. Somebody says it like this.
Plan it.
Those who fail to plan, they plan to fail.
Yes, if you plan the money, so how can we make money? Yes, to us, they would have planned the system.
If you fail to plan, you plan to fail.
Totally plan it. That's if I'm planning to pattern fit new dash.
Prayer, wonderful.
Molitsa, I'm sure.
Prayer, I believe in prayer.
Me too, you very molit.
You believe in prayer.
Very, very molit.
Many other people believe in prayer.
In Turkey, to the molesta.
But they pray full stop.
No, molesta, in item, sir.
We have seen the condition.
Even patrons, is
that because all those villages, what are we planning to do? Are we possessing those villages?
Concretely, planning and resolving the cat with many pathology and mission.
Number one, we pray. We prepare. That's what life is all about. That's what progress is all about. Now we get to this village now. We prepare to possess it. As we bought that village, it is all broken down.
No
system is working there. The houses are dilapidated and collapsing. There is no hospital there. There is no clinic there. There is no welfare center in that village. Even to buy common ordinary things, all those things are not available. What is our preparation to make that village rise up? To bring some modern amenities into that place. And to make that village a place that is habitable. That's why we're talking about preparing. Number four. Pursue. There's something driving you. Your heart is a goal. Your heart is an achievement. There's a beautiful picture of this village as it ought to be. And you're pursuing that plan.
должны быть, но
and you're having that straight course, I'm going this way, and you're checking out. This is done, that is done.
Сели устремление, потому что будет очень много пунктов, которые захотят вас отбить, чтобы сдать, чтобы уехать, чтобы бросить. Должны быть сели устремление, чтобы довести свой план.
You have a master plan for that city of refuge.
Да, у нас есть свои видения о том, чтобы построить эти города.
And as you are repairing this and putting that in place, you are checking out with the master plan.
No. Нужно всегда не просто делать вещи автоматически, а нужно проверять, что мы исполняем то видение, те планы, которые мы
check up the organization, the management, the rehabilitation, everything.
Вот почему планы нужны, чтобы мы могли все контролировать постоянно, что мы совпадаем, по срокам совпадаем.
And the people who are living there.
И люди, которые с нами работают.
You are getting them through the process of that rehabilitation.
Мы контролируем то, что максимальное количество людей становится шансы команды.
You're checking up how much of your goal have you reached.
И мы проверяем, получается ли у нас таким количеством людей достичь ту цель, которую мы
поставили. How much of your goal are you still to reach?
Достигнем ли мы такое количество, через сколько лет, через
какое количество лет. And pursue.
Вот почему нужно быть целеустремленными.
Point number five.
На план, по плану.
Is perseverance, persevere.
Следующий пункт, должна быть долготерпение.
Sometimes we get tired.
Долготерпение нужно, потому что
sometimes this may not be created.
Ведь на всех нас придут атаки.
He professed in good profession.
И даже усталость придет.
And we were even happy about his life.
Разочарование придет.
But then we discover.
No.
We discover yes. That the fellow is already secretly smoking.
Но зачастую мы видим, человек приходит, он такой лидер, посвященный, а потом обнаруживаем, человек уже где-то курит.
We come into an apartment.
Он уже в потемочку кричит.
And he didn't open the door in time.
И мы приходим, там был гостей.
By the time he opened the door,
he was
hiding something in
the corner. Мы а он не открывает, а потом открыли.
He become inquisitive.
И по глазам уже видим,
something going on here.
Парень уже...
And then you go to check up.
А потом мы задаем ему вопрос.
What is this?
Что это такое?
Oh, then began to talk, he began to say, actually, my friend came here last night. I said no, but he forced me into it. And the goal you are pursuing, you see. Is it worth it? That's why we need to persevere.
Такие искушения будут ко всем, если мы с вами не будем долготерпеливы, чтобы преодолевать все искушения.
There's a verse of scripture I love in Judges chapter 8.
Суди, 8 глава.
It's a wonderful verse of scripture.
Суди, 8 глава.
Judges chapter 8, verse 4.
Четвертый стих.
In this verse of scripture,
8, 4.
It says Gideon came to Jordan and passed over, he and the 300 men that what we see, they were faint, yet pursuing them.
И пришел Гедеон к Иордану, перешел сам, и 300 человек, бывшие с ним. Они были утомлены, преследуя врагов.
They were faint, they were tired.
Представьте, они преследуя врагов, но при
этом
они утомились.
It's like, can we still go on?
То есть, когда мы преследуем наши цели, утомление и искушение.
You are doing something good.
Когда мы проводим неделю правильно,
you want to do finish everything within 5 weeks.
At
the end of the 5 weeks, the people you are trying to rehabilitate and clean up and help, they have not gone up to stage one week of your program.
You утомлены, когда приходит, когда тем, кому ты помогаешь. Вроде ты им помогаешь, но они тебе подводят еще. Ты ожидаешь от одного, они тебе еще винят.
And the person looks undependable.
Тебе делают еще вино.
He is unsteady.
Они тебе подводят.
And then his parents, they are not saying thank you. They are not saying they love you for what you are doing.
Мало того, что те по твоим починам тебе подводят, еще твои лидеры тебе винят за это, что ты виноват.
And the religious people around him, they say, what are you doing? Leave a child alone. Let him, we prefer that he will die in alcoholism than you helping him with your religious method.
Мало того, что твои лидеры тебе не поняли, еще и родственники начинают в это время на тебе набрасаться.
And when they say that, it will discourage you.
International success taroka tatakia taki to what is that should we look here
for why are we wasting our time?
You got to go come next to
a young man is not making the progress we expected.
And that barren deep no kavo ya spasal on me ya vinay on the primimai pomoshi on me ya isho da me ya goni.
His spirits are not saying thank you.
Univoni shivoni pomusha isa moyi leader me ya nipani ma.
The religious people around him are not saying thank you.
Religious moyi fast by a circle by a sabi toje nipani ma.
We fast and we pray.
They don't see
our fasting and prayer. They say it is psychology and hypnotism. And so we ourselves have become discouraged. That's the time you keep on pursuing even though you are faint.
Слушайте, я вам секрет скажу. Именно тогда, когда вы утомлены, и вам хочется сдаваться. Secret somewhere glamour Jesus, even not like that which another break.
We will not listen to all those outside forces.
Even not like that, нужно больше всего напрягаться, потому что тогда значит у него вон награды прорыва.
The next thing is pay the price.
Следующий пункт это ведет к тому, что
pay the price.
Нужно научиться платить цены.
Pay the price.
Цену нужно платить за
успех. There is no pill that costs nothing. Precious pearls, precious gold, they are very costly. And if
you
are going to have a pearl or gold, you must pay the price.
And these
people God is helping you to resolve. They are precious pearls in the kingdom of God.
That is passat nudei eta tujil.
And you are the one going to bring that pearl out of the ground where it is buried.
No, jemshujil eti anis preatani grezi.
And you clean it up.
Greasy. And the stage another cup of grass.
And you make him a trophy for the kingdom of God.
Sapaj katsa. You don't have a coin or a terra. Apatom jemshujil prashisti that is jemshujil.
Don't be guilty of doing nothing.
You know,
there are many people that do not understand doing nothing is a sin.
But yesterday, we were supporting the Ustalos. Most of us said, "Ah, no, she was not doing anything."
They say, "I'm free from alcoholism."
No, remember that. We did that. She won. We planted seed. We
agreed. They don't have the sin of alcoholism.
Yes, the way is catch the show, we should know.
I'm free from drugs. I'm free from drugs.
If we push it, it's losing to be at
the sin of using hard drugs.
Their
sin is I was sick and he visited me not.
In Greek, best daily. Greek, потому что Иисус говорит, потом скажет тому человеку, я был болен, ты не посетил меня. Я был нагим, ты меня не одел.
I was homeless, you didn't shelter me.
Я был в тюрьме, ты меня не посетил.
It is a sin of doing nothing.
Бог это называется грехом.
Don't be guilty of the sin of doing
nothing. Это грех, за который Бог потом будет судить.
That's why the grace of God, we're going to do something.
No, я думал, что вы не будете виновными.
That's why we're here.
Бог, я думал, вы поэтому пришли сюда.
And the Lord will use all of us together.
Потому что вы будете действовать, правда ли?
The cities of refuge will be built.
И Господь будет вас использовать.
In different parts of this country.
И через вас Господь
будет here.
Многие спасутся через вас.
The final thing I want to look at.
И последнее, о чем я хочу говорить.
The proposed dwellers in built cities. Proposed dwellers. Those who are going to live there.
In these cities.
In those cities of refuge.
Okay. Теперь судьба будущей жителей этих городов и убежища.
Now, let's say we build a city.
Допустим, нам мы создаем эти города и убежища.
Cleaned up alcoholics.
Мы собираем туда людей.
Ex-drug addicts.
Наркоманов, бомжей, туристов, убежища.
This particular city of refuge.
И мы построили.
Can take about 5,000 people.
Скажем, эти города выросли до 5000.
But we only have 100 people living there.
No, this село может жить 5000.
What's the proposal in getting other people to live there?
Or do we
just leave those 100 people there?
If those 100
people, 90 of them are men and 10 of them are women. How will those many men get married? If all those people that are living there is no engineer, there is no nurse, there is no doctor, how will that village or that city of refuge be self-sufficient? The way they did it in Nehemiah's time. How those cities, when the city was built, there's security,
and there's
good provision.
And
how did they make people to come to live there? Nehemiah chapter 11. And there we read from verse
1.
And the rulers of the people dwelt at Jerusalem. And the rest of the people also cast lots to bring one out of 10 to dwell in Jerusalem.
And
9 parts to dwell in other cities. And the people blessed all the men that were willing, that willingly offered themselves to dwell at Jerusalem.
И благословил народ всех, которые добровольно согласились жить в Иерусалиме.
The built of Jerusalem.
And it was really good,
but it was not properly inhabited or dwelt in. The wells are built up, the walls are built up.
So yes, that good refugee, yes.
The city is built up.
Stand as the
but it's empty.
No, Naruda.
So they said, what are we going to do? They said, all of you here, give one out of 10, transfer them to Jerusalem. They said, everybody, all the other cities,
must
contribute 10% to come and live in this empty, vacant city. And then there will be managers, there will be rulers, there will be leaders, there will be organizers, and we choose them. You are going to live in this place. And then they said, other people that want to volunteer, you'll come and live here. We must think about that as we look at all the cities where all the cities were repossessing. All these villages, were repossessing. Are there people that will volunteer? Engineers, educationists, different kinds of professions.
And
we say, live in that other place. So that all those cities of refuge should be self-sufficient. We can do it. Nehemiah did it. Other people supported Nehemiah, it was done. All we need is to have a desire to see it happen. It will happen. In a few years, in Jesus' time, it's another 5 years, another 10 years, this nation will see righteousness as principle of the kingdom in all these cities of
refuge.
And when the government begins to investigate and study and find the secret of kingdom principle in all these cities to apply for the nation, there's hope for this nation.
They
will pray that in your night time it will be done.
Это состоится при вашей жизни. Своими глазами
вы увидите.
Ведь вы стали номерами и руководите на вертикале на
войне.
Я пророчествую, что вы будете Неемиями. Это поколение в Айве Иисусе. Станьте на то, давай куда молиться. Молись, чтобы станете Неемиями. Имени Иисуса. Это не будет кровь, это не народа.
Я вас уже слушаю четвертый раз, и такое ощущение, вот сегодня, вроде вы все знаете, все знаете и были среди нас, все видели, как это происходит, что делается. Ну, это ну, честно говоря, это нонсенс. То есть вы особый человек. Спасибо вам огромное.
Хочу поблагодарить тоже, пастор. Да, есть огромная, наверное. Спасибо большое вам, семья. Тоже. Вот. Ну, как бы слово, знаете, начиная, наверное, с того первого, то, что вы говорили, да, о бремени. Вот. И вот когда уже в конце вы говорили о том, что действительно нужно создать что-то, чтобы ну, люди хотели туда приезжать, в эти села хотели приезжать, создать ну, что-то, поднимать этих людей, вот, знаете. И на самом деле кажется, ну, что очень как бы, великое, большое и недоступное, где-то вот внутри себя я чувствую. Но с другой стороны я поняла, что если у меня есть и будет бремя за людей, привести людей к Богу, спасать людей, то, ну, как бы, какие бы высоты, то есть это на самом деле, ну, достижимо, то, что, ну, то, что вы говорите, и это можно сделать для Царства Божьего. Поэтому я благодарю Бога за то, что вы есть, за то, что пастор Сандей пригласил вас сюда. Вот. И то, что ну, вообще все эти лидерские, которые здесь вы проводите на сегодняшний день, это действительно помогает нас что-то это лично делать с моим сердцем очень серьезно. То есть свидетельствовать, говорить людям о Боге, больше говорить. Потому что вот мы буквально недавно, вот Александр когда вел и говорил, что вот это вот там столько много у нас целей, задач, столько всего мы много делаем, и временами где-то упускаются какие-то определенные вещи. Вот. И ну, вот вы принесли как какую-то, знаете, свежесть такую о том, что ну, вроде бы просто, ничего сложного, вроде бы как бы мы это понимаем, но что-то упустили. И вы принесли то, что лично в мою жизнь. Ну, обновление, просто вот свидетельствовать людям, общаться, приводить вот это вот бремя. Потом большое спасибо вам за то, что вы есть и служите нам здесь. Это большое благословение. И мне кажется, что я, наверное, в полной мере, может быть, не осознаю, ну, действительно, насколько вы муж Божий. Я просто в своем сердце говорю, Боже мой, я хочу еще больше и больше понять и осознать, ну, что за человек вот, ну, вы, да, что за подарок, что за дар для каждого из нас. Потом просто принимаю верой вот этого, ну, может быть, необъятное, недоступное для меня. Вот, я просто принимаю, что действительно мы великие, мы не имеем, мы сделаем это, то есть для Бога и для Царства Божьего. Спасибо.
Я тоже в первую очередь хочу выразить свою благодарность вам, пастор Сандай, и вам, пастор Кумуи. Я настолько сейчас переполнен чувствами по одной простой причине, потому что если человек, истинно, ну, муж Божий, которого знает весь мир, говорит сейчас о вещах таких, которыми мы живем, ну, я просто еще раз убедился в том, что это все настолько реально, и что действительно будут эти города-убежища, действительно мы будем в руководстве этой страны, мы будем поднимать новых людей, новый генофон этой страны. У меня просто каждый пункт во мне что-то переворачивалось, потому что я понимаю, что я так живу каждый день. И когда я осознаю, что об этих вещах сейчас говорит человек мирового масштаба, и оно во мне есть, я понимаю, что результатом этого будет то все, о чем нас учат, о чем нас говорят. Я просто преклоняю свои колени, мне спасибо за то, что я вырос в этой церкви, за то, что мы правильно все воспитаны, за то, что ну, в нас вложили все то, чем живет настоящее христианство. Я просто еще раз убедился в том, что правильно мы идем. Большое спасибо вам, пастор. Большое спасибо вам, пастор.
Мне так лежит на сердце. Я с самого начала об этом думал и хочу сказать, пастор, вам, потому что им нужно обладать авторитетом перед Богом, чтобы такие люди приезжали к вам. То есть вы разделяете часть своих возможностей и успеха с нами. И мы, как представители данного городового убежища,
Отдельно пастор Сандей пригласил великого человека, чтобы мы услышали вживую, живое слово, глаголы, ну, глаголы жизни. И когда была, воспользуюсь сейчас случаем, была домашняя группа, у меня было какое-то двоякое чувство попросить, подойти и попросить у пастора Кумуи, чтобы он помолился за меня. У меня это уже стало навязчивой идеей. Пастор Наталья уже за меня молилась в Королево за двойное помазание. У пастора Сандея, нашего любимого, я выпросил это двойное помазание, чтобы он за меня помолился. И теперь я имею честь и попросить вас, чтобы вы помолились еще раз за меня. Преклонить колени перед Богом и чтобы вы возложили на меня руки, потому что, ну, это дух внутри возбуждает. Это нужно сделать. Поэтому я буду очень благодарен и признателен вам, если вы это сделаете.
Let us pray. A great God in heaven. A first national person. What a great day. A veliki day is a great day of a great vision. A veliki day, veliko of a great impartation. Veliko of a great day.